Respected jury members, good afternoon, respected jury members, faculty members, and my dear student managers. My name is Abhas, and I am from Saraswati River.
My name is Sairaj, and I am from Saraswati.
And today we are going to present our presentation, induction presentation, on a study on failure of Nokia. Yes, it is a failure story, but no doubt it has become a reason for many success stories. Before coming to this, I have one simple question for all of you. How many of you had Nokia as a first phone? You had first phone as a Nokia. Big number. And one more question. How many of you have iPhone? Not a big number. Okay, no problem. Why iPhone? Why not Vivo or Oppo? Brand, exactly. On that, I have one small story I would like to narrate. In 2005, when I was in Manipur, I was privileged to meet then CM, Okram Ibobi Singh. Then I saw him using simple handset, 1100. He could have purchased or effort to get any costly mobile phone. But he preferred to use Nokia 1100. Why? Because it was a brand that time. Nokia was a big brand capturing the whole market. And suddenly, what happened to the Nokia that it declined so very fast? Now, today we are going to discuss about these things only. Next slide.
Gentlemen, play the video.
Next slide.
This is the evolution of Nokia phones.
Okay, today we are going to cover this bullet points, like the first introduction, then revenue, market shares, and competitor analysis, ineffective marketing strategy, failure reasons, and current status, and conclusion. Next one. Okay, if we talk about Nokia, it was founded in 1865, but it started its business with wood pulp mill. Then they switched to rubber business. And then again in 1902, they started electricity business. And in 1967, they merged all the three and started a corporation called Nokia Corporation. And the story begins from there. And from there, in its early decade, Nokia covered its huge market. Like it covers, it has a market share of globally market share of 40%, and it emerged from the Finland and covers the whole market share. And you won't believe, till 2007, it covered the 80% of the market share of the mobile phone market.
Okay, we'll have a look on to the revenue part. This is the annual quarterly revenue and growth rate from 2006 to 2019. We have a bar chart over there. On y-axis, we have year-on-year quarterly growth. On x-axis, we are having the years. Okay, the decline of the Nokia revenue for 12 months. We are having the latest figure as on of 31st March of 2019. That was 1.803 lakh crores of Indian rupees, and that was 0.66% decline a year. That was with the consideration of the previous year. With respect to the previous year, we have a decline of 0.66%. And if you have a look on the declining part of the bar chart, we'll get to know that the revenue decreased in that in the year from 2012 to 2016. That was because of the change in the upper management, and when Nokia shifted from Nokia Corp to Microsoft, when Microsoft acquired Nokia, there was managemental failures. The decision making failed and at the upper level, so Nokia suffered a huge loss, and that was between 2013 to 2015. We have annual revenue for 2016 that was 1.76 lakh crores of Indian rupees, and we have that at that time Nokia was there was an increase in Nokia's revenue of 88.28%. And in 2003 and 2005, Nokia captured 50% of its consumer electronic market share in India. Okay, we are having a pie chart over there. Mobile infrastructure market share, which was published in 2017 by IHS Market and Counterpoint. Nokia is having a 23% of total market share globally. At that time, total overall smartphone plus other comms and IT sector. Okay, we are looking at a competitor analysis. When Microsoft purchased Nokia, then the Stefan Elop, the new CEO, the new the manager, the new the new strategy making leader of Microsoft and Nokia, he made some new strategies into 2013, and that led to the decline of total market share, and its competitors Apple and Samsung gone up to the market. They have reached the peaks, and Nokia fallen down till 2012.
As I was talking, what happened that Nokia suddenly declined? There are a few reasons, but what I personally believe, there were internal rivalries during that time, and somewhere Nokia was trying to create a monopoly. They were just trying to go alone in the market, but as we know, in market it is probably not possible to go alone in the market. So the first thing that Nokia loses customer trust was taken over by other companies like Apple, and so many other companies was there, and selling and distribution management was not proper, and lack of innovations, failure to implement the right umbrella branding strategy, and wrong decision making deal with Microsoft. As my friend said, Stefan Eloff, the then CEO, took very bad decision of merging Nokia with Microsoft and using Windows as operating system, and management decisions and dysfunctional organizational structures, as I mentioned.
Yes. When we come to failure reasons, Nokia was adopting a lean manufacturing system in Europe, while their competitors such as Xiaomi, Vivo, they were adopting into mass manufacturing system. They were manufacturing the products, then the mobile phones, on larger scale than as compared to the Nokia. There was a birth of user-friendly operating system, and wrong OS acquisition was done by Nokia itself, because it moves from Symbian directly to the Windows. Nokia was having shortage of software developers. That was also a primary reason to decrease its revenue. It was having a poor distributor and retail network, and Stefan Elop's poor will also resulted in the failure of Nokia. Current status, currently Nokia is operating its business under HMD Global. It is manufacturing its smartphone under Foxconn. Software related services of Nokia was growing at 4% in 2018. Its global Nokia technologies was growing at 19% in 2018. And here's the conclusion. Stefan Elop's negative will lead to the failure of Nokia. That was a primary point. Avoidance to cope with the advancing world. Second most important point that Nokia dealt with, lacking in the adoption of new technologies, focused innovation, and neglecting feedback. Yes, that was the major playing point. of downgrading Nokia, failure in OS, and deal with Microsoft lowers its market value.
Slide, next slide.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Just